So, Astro, when it comes to divorce, I had read about the difficulty of or the process of divorce in the Church of Scientology. How does that actually work?
Well, when I was in the Church of Scientology, I was in what's called the Sea Organization, which is their military-like organization that runs all the day-to-day operations. I left when I was 19, and I was actually pregnant with my daughter, and my husband wanted to remain in the Sea Org, so we were ordered to get a divorce. I was told that if I wanted to leave, that I was to file for divorce because they wanted to keep him in the Sea Org. And you can't really have people who are in the Sea Org married to people who are not in the Sea Org. So
there's a term that in the church that they use called they label some people as a suppressive person, an SP.
Yes.
What does that mean?
Well, anyone who speaks out publicly in a negative way about Scientology would be labeled a suppressive person. And they also label people that for various other reasons, but that would be one of the main reasons. Or if you're just known to be critical of Scientology, they would label you a suppressive person, in which case any family members, friends, or spouse that you have who's a Scientologist would be told to disconnect from you
and
not have anything.
When you left the church, your mom was still in the church, so you didn't have contact with her for a long period of time.
My mom, my grandma, my brother are all still in the church, and I haven't had contact with them in years. In fact, I haven't. I've seen my mom once in about 12 years.
You got married when you were 15. Was it common in the Sea Organization to get married that young?
It was very common, yeah. Girls would go to Las Vegas all the time to get married because in California you couldn't get married under the age of 16.
When you were 19, you got pregnant, and I know you say you actually got pregnant in an attempt to be able to leave the Sea Organization. I don't know. How did that work?
It sounds a little confusing, but they came out with a rule about a year before I left. They said, if you're in the Sea Org, you can't have children. Women who got pregnant were put under a lot of pressure to have abortions. They decided that children were a distraction, that they didn't want to have to financially support them. So they said, that's it, no more children. So you were expected to have an abortion if you got pregnant. The few women who refused would be thrown out. I got pregnant and refused to have an abortion, and after about a month of pressure and interrogation, they finally let me leave.
We reached out to the church for comment about some of your experiences. They didn't respond. In a piece that Glamour magazine did about you, the church did respond, saying that you were not a reliable source, that your allegations are untrue, that you were happy in the church and are now, quote, being used by someone who doesn't like the church. How do you respond to that?
Well, it's just not true. I mean, I only spoke out about my experiences to educate people, and because the whole point in Scientology is they suppress the freedom of speech. They don't let you talk about anything. That I kind of felt for my own well-being, my own form of therapy, that it was important to talk about what happened. I mean, they can say I'm not a reliable source, but I worked there for 5 years and I knew exactly what went on. And I also have a lot of documentation. So I think it's a bit of a weak response for them because they don't really know how to respond to what I've said because it's true. And I'm not saying it for any other reason than it's what happened. And I don't really want it to happen to other children.
Astro left the church some 14 years ago. As we mentioned, we asked the Church of Scientology to respond to her allegations. At the time I did that interview about an hour or two ago, they had not responded directly to Astro's allegations. Late tonight, we got a statement which reads in part, quote, "The church regrets that excommunicated, self-serving apostates are sadly exploiting private family matters to further their hate-filled agendas against their former faith. Having left the church many years ago, these sources have no current knowledge about the church and their recollections are distorted by their animosity."